went to the market with his three donkeys and he wanted to make a sale and earn some living out of it. But what happened is, while he was passing the road, he saw a river and he thought he should take a bath. And unfortunately, he only had two ropes. And then he thought, what will I do? How will I tie all my three donkeys now? Kept on thinking about it, nothing happened. Then finally, he met a wise man on the way and he asked him, that this is what I want to do, how do I accomplish it? The wise man said, I don't have a rope for you, but I have a bright idea for you. He said, okay, tell me. He says, what you do is, go and tie these two donkeys with these ropes and make sure that the third one watches the whole process. The farmer does the same thing. He exactly does the same. He does all that what the wise man said and goes and makes the bath. Comes back. To his surprise, he sees all the three donkeys standing exactly where they were supposed to stand. He gets very excited, unties the two donkeys and starts to walk. Now when he's walking, just turns around and sees that the third donkey is still standing at the same place. Again, he tries to cajole him, pushes him, pulls him, pats him, and makes sure that he's walking with him. The third donkey refuses to walk. He meets the wise man again and says, wise man, you gave me this idea, but now the third one is not refusing to walk with me and is not really walking. What should I do? Again, the wise man said, did you untie the third donkey? He looks at him and says, but I never tied them. How do I untie them? He said, the wise man says to the farmer, you know you have not tied the donkey, but the donkey doesn't know about it. Now what happens is the farmer goes, makes an imaginary motion to untie the donkey, and sure enough, the third donkey starts to walk and soon joins the two other donkeys. My friends, the story tells us that there is something which is far more seen than unseen. The untangible, the unseen ropes which your mind has can stop you from taking that step forward. Most often in my practice, I see that the business owners, they take all the opportunities now in their way. They try to see whatever they can possibly do. But unfortunately, this unseen rope does not allow them to go forward. In their calculated risk, the fear, the hesitation, all of them stops them from looking at the right support, looking at the right opportunity, and looking at that amazing stuff which is right in front of them. My name is Dr. Meghna Dixit. This is what everybody knows about me in DNI that I do. I had been given an opportunity to give into a workshop in DNI, so thank you for that. These are my awards and achievements, some media presence. This is what exactly I do always. This is what I love doing. And apart from what I do to in my business and also my passion to help people, this is what I do very often, and people here know me that I keep traveling often. Thanks Ajay for sharing my burning desire. What is NLP? Like my category is NLP Master Practitioner. What is NLP? Success is 80% your mindset and 20% your skill. Everybody here sitting in this room knows their 20% skills. But 80% mindset, which nobody knows how deep we are going and what we need to do about. So here we are, NLP focuses on getting over your deepest fears that causes ultimate stress and becomes a roadblock in your path to success. What I do is coaching for entrepreneurs and coaching for students. Rahul, may I request you to run the testimonial, please? This is a gentleman who is from Cross Chapter of DNI. I met him at one of my first MSP, what I did in 20 days of my joining DNI, and this is his testimonial.
My name is Abhiraj Shetty and I am Director of Academics at Shetty's Institute of Academics Kalyan and a business networking event that I met Dr. Meghna. She introduced herself as a person who would be able to drive away the fear of mathematics for kids. And she had a lot of case studies to support that. So my daughter being in class 8, and I was concerned about her mathematics. And so I approached her. As luck would have it, Sierra was benefited obviously, but two of that also went up to Meena a number of times. And through our interactions, I realized that I could also gain some advantage and benefit in life. It definitely assisting us in setting up systems, setting up processes. The emotional part, the personal part of it, is not looked at after the regular business coach, with due respect. That is one part that Dr. Meena's sessions have helped me as a person, as an individual, and shape us as an organization. And it comes from someone who has been a trainer at international level, and who has been a TEDx speaker herself, who transforms lives. When it comes from that person, it makes an impact. And it's not just hollow words. And when these things are channelized through the sessions that I do with Dr. Meena, definitely it has complemented the number of work or the statistical work or the process work that the business coaching has done. Thanks to Dr.